In my current research, we are looking at links between experiences related to poverty in earlier childhood, middle childhood, early adolescence, and how those experiences relate to how the brain responds to different cues in the environment at that time. We're then trying to see how those patterns of brain function that are particularly sensitive, perhaps, to those early poverty-related experiences then relate to different kinds of outcomes for youth, such as depression and other kinds of problems as well. From a psychological perspective, given my own background in that, is to consider the poverty that they feel that they experience. Do they notice differences between themselves and others? And is that notice of a difference internalized for them in their experience every day and interacting and engaging in school? Quite a lot of thinking has been focused on the dynamics in the family that are influenced by the experiences of poverty, which can be quite stressful. And it's through those experiences of stress that puts strain, for example, on interactions between parents, interactions between parents and children. In addition, the resources that are available for children. So it's through these other mechanisms, potentially through the family, that might link poverty with brain development. We might be able to work with individuals in terms of how they respond to different situations in their environments. And so by identifying areas of the brain that might be more or less sensitive to your earlier experiences, we can use that information to help us perhaps create trainings or interventions that can help people maybe reframe how they interpret different kinds of situations or different kinds of interactions or experiences that they have in their day-to-day lives.